So justice for you in this case would be what?
I don't.
With bullet fragments still buried under his skin, we're going to hear from the man who was shot when a suspect fired a barrage of bullets at the Cheektowaga Dollar General. And good evening, everyone. In an exclusive interview, the victim in that shooting spree that happened 10 days ago shares his horrifying tale. Channel 2's Dave McKinley sat down with John Schaefer, who is giving thanks, perhaps more than most of us.
Amid family, friends, and food, the holidays remind us of all we are grateful for, especially John Schaefer.
And a lot to be thankful for, I guess.
Yes, I'm lucky I'm here.
The 53-year-old night cleaner at Damon College had gone to this Union Road Dollar General 10 days ago to buy styrofoam coffee cups when he noticed a man assaulting a woman in the parking lot.
He punched her twice in the face, so I got on my phone. I called the police.
But then that man, later identified as 29-year-old Travis Green, turned his attention to John.
He approached me and said to me, "Do you have a problem or is there something wrong?" And I says, "No." And he goes to me, who are you talking to? I said, "I'm talking to a friend." He goes, "Get off your phone." And I says, "No, I'm talking to my friend." He goes, "Get off your goddamn phone." And then he punched me in the face twice and I dropped my phone. He kicked it away from me. Then he just walked away to go to his car. So I picked up my phone. I started talking to the police department again.
While heading to the store where he'd hoped to find refuge, he got through the outside set of doors, but then found the second set of doors into the store locked by the staff inside, which had taken shelter.
So I couldn't get in because the doors didn't open.
Where is he at this point?
He was still outside.
He then turned to look at a terrifying scene.
And I saw him standing by the car, and he pulled out a black bag and he dropped it, and then he pulled the rifle out and he shot two shots in the air.
Inside this vestibule, Schaefer hunkered down for cover.
And the next thing you know, he just started shooting up the store, and I ducked in a corner.
Police say Green had two rifles and 800 rounds of ammunition. Schaefer says the shooting stopped and Green took off amid the sounds of approaching police sirens. Two witnesses from a nearby business recalled the same and started chasing Green, eventually following him up to a Union Road overpass where police, as seen in this dash cam video, collared him. Schaefer had also gone up to see what had transpired, but there was something of which he was unaware.
And one of the detectives come up to me and goes, "Do you know you're bleeding?" I says, "No," and they cut my shirt and jacket off and I had a fragment of a bullet in my shoulder.
And you didn't even know this?
No, I didn't even know it.
Doctors at ECMC quickly determined that he'd been shot all right, a fragment in his shoulder, which still remains.
And then they said about this, if it works its way to come out, they want the evidence.
Oh, so they didn't dig it out of there?
No, they said they could have, but it could have caused damage.
Oh.
To my nerves.
So you've got like a souvenir right now?
Yes.
Green's mother told us that her son, now facing decades in prison, had been despondent over the loss of a job and a marriage and apparently snapped.
I understand if he went through a lot, but what about all these other people that go through a lot and are under a lot of stress? Are they out there shooting people up?
He'd tell him that too, perhaps in not so many words.
I don't know what I would really say to him.
Probably something you can't say on TV anyway.
Yeah. I would say. Yes.
He'll save the most important words for his wife of more than 20 years, Cindy, who is still shaken by the ordeal. Words of love, comfort, and gratitude that their life together can and will continue. Dave McKinley, Channel 2 News.
Dave, thank you. John Schaefer did end up losing something in the shooting spree, his car. It was so bullet-ridden that the insurance adjuster has now decided he's going to have to total that vehicle.